Welcome to our weekend workouts. This week I'm going to run through a Thera-Band workout. So if you have one of these guys at home, you can definitely use it and we can teach you how to get a full body workout in. If you don't have something like that, maybe you have something that's more loopy or you have something with handles that works as well, as long as it's kind of resisted and elastic. That's what we're basically going to be doing. So we're going to go through eight exercises, three sets of 30 seconds work, 30 seconds rest. So lots of time to recover in between. And so yeah, let's get into our warm up, starting with leg swings. So forward, back, getting the hips going, loosen up. Switch sides, back and forth. Good. Let's go to lateral. Get our groin and glutes. And switch sides. Great. Move on to squats. So just shoulder width apart, just trying to warm up the legs a little bit. Nothing too intense. But getting ready for our workout where we're going to have some resisted squats. And we can get into lunges. So we're going to step back, then step forward, step back, and forward, back, forward, back, forward, and switch. Good. Let's work on our upper body now. Some arm swings. So open up the chest, cross your hands over, alternate which arm's on top, which arm's on the bottom. You can even shake it your legs a little bit after those squats and lunges. Get the blood flowing back. Couple breaths. And we'll get into arm circles. So palms down, slowly get bigger till we can get to fulls, whatever your full rotation may be. And palms up in reverse, same thing. Slowly increase until we can get to full rotations. And that's great. All right, let's get into our workout. So starting with TheraBand squats. So we're gonna grab our band, put it underneath our feet, hip width apart, come over top of our shoulders like this, drop down, pop up, drop down, pop up. So we started a little late. So we're gonna go another 15 seconds here. Cut our rest a little short on set one. Great job, and rest. So I'm going to show you a lateral view next. So the reason why I like the TheraBand squats is because it helps us get into a lower position. So the band's kind of pulling us down, gets us through a bigger range of motion. And then you kind of have to work against it to get back up. All right, let's get going. Round two. So you can see from the side here, my back posture. Trying to stay nice and upright, nice and tall, Chest is pointing forward. And relax. Great job, everyone. We got one more set, and then we're going to move into anterior raises. So I'll show you what it would look like with one of the loops for our third round. So with the loops, same concept. You just put it underneath your feet, and then we would just hold up like that across our chest. So we drop down, come back up, drop down, come back up. Great, let's get going if you haven't already started. Round three. And relax. Perfect. So get a drink of water if you need it. Catch your breath quickly. Then we're going to get into our second exercise. So anterior raises. We're going to do one arm at a time. So you can loop this around, and we're just going to come straight forward for 15, and then we're going to switch and do the other arm. So let's get started. It's 15 seconds. You're really feeling it more so at the end. So if it's not strenuous at the end, adjust the tension until it is. Switch sides. And relax. Great job. So if you found that too easy, what you can do is take the band and hold it in both hands there, or both sides in one hand. And so when we come up, you have double the amount of tension. That may be too difficult for you, but I'm going to give it a shot. So you can see, so I'm coming up, nice good pause, coming just above shoulder height, come back down, just above shoulder height, come back down. Switch sides. And relax. And again, I'll show you how it would work if we're using a loop. Same concept, you're just going to find your tension. So, what I'll do is I'll just kind of cross it over a little bit, or I'll wrap it around my hand once or so if I don't have the right tension. And let's get going. So up, pause, back down. Up, pause, back down. So I like doing this with one arm because it really helps focus on that side. And you have to use your core so you don't do your little teapot routine. Switching sides, finding the right tension. Up, back down. Up, pause, back down. Up, pause, back down. Perfect. So that's our first two exercises. The next one is going to be a deadlift. So for this, we're going to be stepping on our band, feet shoulder width apart again, wrap around your hands, you're going to hinge forward, and then you're going to pull up with your hamstrings. So the TheraBand's just adding a little bit of resistance here. So hinge forward, pull up. Hinge forward, pull up. So you're going to have to probably have a decent amount of tension here to mimic what it would be like if you're using free weights. First round, we can just get used to the motion, and then I can show you how to make it harder. Good. So let's relax. So round two. Now what we're going to do is double up our TheraBand. And we're going to stand on it and repeat the same thing. So I'm holding both ends here, and it's going to get really tense towards the top, so it's going to be really hard to grip it. So I'm going to get myself ready. Nice good back posture, a little bit of soft knees. Ready and deadlift. And relax. Great job. So again, I'm going to show in group three or round three how to use the loop to do the same exercise. Although you probably found the resistance band deadlifts a lot easier than you would with dumbbells, I really like them because again, they get you down to that full they really pull you down so you get a full range of motion, so you're not cheating. All right, so let's get into round three here. It should be really hard to grip when we get to the top. That way we can get a good amount of tension, make it a little bit more challenging on our muscles. And relax. So that's exercise number three. So we're going to go into number four next, which is a lateral raise. So anterior raise coming forward, lateral raise coming to the side. So same thing, we're going to step on it, get a good grip, find the right tension, and you're going to come up. Pause, come back down. Up, pause, back down. Up, pause, back down. If you have a bit too much tension, you can work your way down it. So I had just a tad too much. And I'm gonna switch sides here. Up, pause, back down. Up, pause, back down. Good. If you notice, I'm really focusing, we can relax. I'm really focusing on keeping my arm straight. Very common to cheat with dumbbells and have a big elbow bend. So from a lateral view, I see a lot of this happen at the gym, so you can use extra weight. So with the TheraBand, really focus on coming out laterally and keeping our arms nice and straight. Get ready for round two. And go. Switch sides. And relax. And we got one more set coming up with the lateral raises, and then we're going to go into a reverse lunge. So I'll show the loops. Same concept. You probably get the point. You can use either one. So using the loop, wrapping it around, standing tall, up, pause, back down. So I do find that with strength bands, they are quite a bit tougher, and switch sides. So individuals that don't have as good of strength as others may find the loops, the strength bands too tough for an exercise like this. And relax. But it all depends on our abilities. We're all different. So we're halfway through the workout. It's a little bit of an easier one than normal, but you can make it as tough as you want. So we're going to get into reverse lunges next. We're going to step on the band with our front leg, and then the opposite arm is going to hold the band. What we're going to do is step back, and the arm comes overhead, and then step forward. So step back, arm overhead, step forward. Back, forward. Back, forward. Back, forward, and switch. And relax. Great job, everyone. Keep working. I know leg exercises are tough for a lot of people, so they avoid them, but not us. Get yourself ready. Couple breathers. And go. Step back. Step forward. So step back, arms overhead, step forward. So you see that big exaggerated lunge, keeping some tension in through the band. Switch sides if you haven't already. Just makes our core work a little bit more. And relax. So that's what we're trying to do with the overhead, with the resistance from the band, is just get our core a little bit more involved. A lot of the times when we do reverse lunges, even in our warm-ups, we probably don't have our core as involved as it should be. So we get a little sloppy. Adding the band in doesn't give us that choice. So let's get ready and go. Last reverse lunge. And switch sides. And relax. Great job. Forgot to switch into the loops there, but it's again, same thing all the way through. Just a lot of resistance there. So we're gonna go into band pull-aparts next. For this one, most of you are gonna have to double up your band. You're gonna hold it about shoulder width apart, and then we're gonna pull it apart like that. So when it's doubled up, I need to start a little bit wider than that. So let's open, close, open, close, like that. So find your distance where you can open up fully, squeeze your shoulder blades together, pause in the open position, and then return back to normal. And relax. So that's our first one of those. I'll show you a lateral view next. So band pull-aparts are definitely one of the most often used exercises with the TheraBand. It's kind of the equivalent of a kettlebell swing with a kettlebell. And it's a really good one for people who sit in their desks all day or do a lot of driving. So very popular with those people. Let's get into round two. Because we sit shoulders rounded in front of a keyboard or in front of a mouse all day, doing movement and strengthening in the opposite direction, where we're opening up our chest, is extremely valuable to us. Kind of offsets all the strain we put on ourselves when we're not, when we're at our computer, and relax. So you're probably feeling that in the back of your shoulders, maybe in your upper back, and then hopefully in your middle back area as well. I'll switch to the loop for the last one, although nothing really changes. So for the loop, I'm just going to wrap my hands around, get ready, and go. So again, it just offers just a different level of resistance. And by round three, I can definitely feel it in my muscles, feeling quite a bit more tired. And relax. So we're through six. We got two more. Next one's our last lower body exercise, which is a monster walk. So another one that's kind of unique to using bands. So for this one, we're going to stand on our bands about shoulder width apart. Hold with a little bit of tension. You're going to step to one side, then step back to shoulder width. So open up, big wide stance, natural stance, wide stance, natural stance. And so we're just going to walk for 15 and then switch directions. This is called the monster walk because you kind of are stiff like Frankenstein or Frankenstein's monster. And relax. It's a really good one for your hips. And again, another popular one for people who sit a lot because you get really tight hips. So definitely if you fall into those categories, you're an office worker, this one should enter your exercise vocabulary. So let's get going, round two. Making sure you're walking laterally. And switch ways. And relax. And for round three, I'll switch back to the loop. This is another one where I kind of prefer the loop for, just because it gives a little bit more tension and it's a little bit easier to work with. So I usually put it in between like the middle of my foot, start myself about shoulder width, and then get into our walks. So I can pull up on this as much as I need to. So if it's not hard enough, I can pull even further. Switch ways. But by round three, a lot of times we don't need a lot of tension because we're already getting pretty fatigued through our hips. And relax. So we got one more exercise, which is a Thera-Band upright row. So for this one, you can probably add a decent amount of tension into it, depending on how strong your back is. You're going to stand on it, wrap it around your hands, a little hinge, and then we're going to drive our elbows up, come back down. Drive our elbows up, back down. It's really trying to pull them up nice and high. And relax. So if you found that too easy, try and wrap it around your feet a bit more, or your hands a little bit more. You can even take a little bit of a wider stance with your feet. We just want a nice little soft knees. So just a little hinge. But I'm going to wrap this a couple times this time so you can see the difference. Lateral view again for you and go. Just drive up, back down. Drive up, back down. Drive up, back down. So it's working on our upper back muscles. And relax. And for our final set, I'll switch back to my loop so you can see that. So, same rules apply. Stand on your loop. I'm going to cross this over just so I can add a bit more tension. And go. So, drive up, back down. Drive up, back down. Drive up, back down. And relax. Great job, everyone. We can put our bands back. And we have a little bit of time before we get into our cool down, our stretching routine. So find yourself a wall if you need it. And we're going to get into our quad stretch to start. So you can grab your foot. Bring your leg underneath, stand nice and tall, hold and breathe. And switch sides, up, hold and breathe. And hamstring stretch. So hinge, toe up, feel the stretch in the back of your leg. And switch sides. Let's go into groin stretch. It's a nice wide stance. Lean to one side. Feel the stretch through your groin. Try and keep your chest nice and tall. And switch sides. Same thing. Nice straight leg on this side. Feeling the stretch through your groin. And glute stretch, so you can do it standing or lying down. So crossing your ankle over top of your knee, sitting into it, feeling the stretch in your butt. Switch sides, same thing. Tricep stretch. So hand or arm overhead, grab the elbow. Nice deep breathing. Switch sides. And chest stretch to finish. Thumb up, but chest to shoulder height. Rotate away till you feel a stretch in through your upper arm and chest and shoulder regions. And let's switch sides. Same thing. And that's it. Hope you enjoyed the TheraBand workout, and we'll see you next week.